So coming from the book of Matthew, chapter 27, verse 45 and verse 46, reads as this: Now from the sixth hour and the ninth hour was darkness all over the land. And about the ninth hour, Jesus cried out with a loud voice, saying, Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani? And that is, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. If we can just go backwards, you know how you parallel park, you kind of go a little forward and then you go a little backwards, okay? So we're going to go forward first and then we're going to go backwards. And we're going to go with the word, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? And you wonder, oh, how Jesus just raced back down 42 generations and got that word that David spoke when he was in agony. He went way back there and he got that word that David said when he was going through, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? And he grabbed that word and he brought it all the way to the cross to let you know that he had already the word. He is the word and he came with the word. All right? All right. And so I said, look at that. How he went back and he got the word and he is the word and he spoke the word and he's teaching us something in the word. So when you pray, you ought to be praying what? In the word. Don't pray anything else. You heard mama pray. You heard daddy pray. But how about we get back in the word and get something to pray? All right? All right. And so he prayed the prayer. And though they both had anguish, they were both different. Yes. They were not the same.
Yes.
Jesus, who knew not sin, prayed that prayer. And here you have David. You know he had fallen again and again and prayed that prayer. But I tell you, in the midst of all your troubles, you got to know what to call on. Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani. Yes, my God,
Jesus,
thou forsaken me. In the moment that you feel left all alone, all by yourself, you know how sin works with you. After it has had its full pleasure with you, the shame and the guilt that it comes upon you. I don't know about you, but something in my spirit just ain't right. It leaves me because I know the Father has turned his back so that he would not see my guilt, my shame.
Come on now.
See, I don't know about you. I don't know when Jesus was on his way to the cross. See, that was Judas. And Judas betrayed him with the kiss. I would have been feeling some type of way.
Come on.
Jesus did not. Because he knew that it had to be fulfilled by the scripture.
Yes.
All right. Yes. I know I would have felt some type of way when he walked up and gave me a kiss. Not only did I say, hurry, eat with you. But then I'm going to get be betrayed with a kiss. Come on. I would have felt some type of way when they came to arrest me. And they had swords. And they had chains. And they held clubs. Like I'm some common criminal. And I'm innocent. I felt some type of way. I don't know about you. I felt some type of way.
Yeah.
When they took and drug me from judgment hall to judgment hall. Trying to come up with some kind of trumped up charges. You know you got some people all up in jail on some trumped up charges. Yeah. And so they're trying to trump up some charges on Jesus. And yet they can't find any. And they say, I found no fault in this man. And Pontius Pilate even comes out trying to wash his hands. But your hands are still guilty with the blood. Come on, man. I would have felt some type of way.
All right.
Oh, God. Oh, you said my time was up. I would have felt some type of way. I would have felt some type of way. Yes, I would have felt some type of way when they took and put a crown of thorns on my head, stripped me of my clothes, mocked me. I would have felt some, I don't know. I would have felt some type of way. But Jesus didn't. He stood there, not said a mumbling word, but he took it. You can't take somebody on your job. I'm talking about you. Why? Because of you, and me. type of way. All that going on, when I got on the cross, I don't know. He got called on, what they say, 12 legions of angels to come by his side. He could have called them, but he didn't. He stood there on the cross. And then they said that it was about the sixth of the night. That was 3 hours in the distance that he's taking on your sins and my sins. Oh, don't act like you all clean, because I got the list. I got the list. You ain't all that clean, squeaky clean. I know when you come out, you got that face on like you're squeaky clean. But behind the closed doors, let your husband tell us something about what you been did or your wife. I don't let somebody on your job begin to tell the story.
All right?
Nobody feels some type of way going through all of that. But Jesus stood on the cross. He had been humiliated. And he took on everything because he was fulfilling the will of his Father.
Yes.
I don't know about you today, but my desire is to feel the will of my Father.
Yes.
And when you get up tomorrow, you ought to have the same feeling.
Yes,
that you want to feel.
Yes, Lord.
The will of the Father.
Yeah.
So I have to say to you, even though times get tough, and it may get a little rough, Eli, lama sabachthani. You say, my God, why have thou forsaken me? Because you're feeling alone. But I want you to be reminded, that wasn't the end of the story. There was a more to the story. Your sins wouldn't be forgiven,
amen.
And neither would mine.
Amen. Amen.